Are you familiar with middle child syndrome? Then you'll know how Ethereum, ETH, has felt all these years. Since January 2020, ETH has trounced Bitcoin, BTC, with a nearly 750% return. Yet the world's number two cryptocurrency received less attention than its big brother, BTC, or problem child XRP. But don't be fooled. Ethereum looks set to break out in 2021. Strap on your seatbelt and hold on tight. It's going to be a wild ride. If you're a subscriber, well, welcome back to Investing View. But if you're new to this channel and you want to enjoy more of our engaging content, make sure to click that subscribe button and use that trigger finger by smashing that like button. Now, let's get into it. Ethereum has become a popular cryptocurrency alternative to Bitcoin over the last year. However, unlike Bitcoin and rival currency Litecoin, Ethereum has been adapted by many companies and startups as a way to transact and more. In the cryptocurrency wars, you can view Ethereum like the diamond of the currencies. It has both an intrinsic value and an industrial value. Compare this to Bitcoin, which operates like gold. Not much industrial value, but people buy it and sell it based on its intrinsic value to the holder. Given the popularity of Ethereum, many people are curious about what it actually is, how it's different than Bitcoin, and how to invest in it. It's also important to note the risks of investing and the potential to mine it and create your own wealth of Ether, the actual monetary unit of Ethereum. Before we dive in, it's important to note that to look at, use, and transact in Ethereum, you need a digital wallet. Now, Ethereum is basically software that is decentralized and allows developers and programmers to run the code of any application. Wait, what? I thought Ethereum was money. Well, it has a monetary aspect. You see, Bitcoin uses a technology called blockchain specifically for conducting monetary transactions. It's a straight currency. Ethereum uses blockchain technology to allow the creation of applications that can be executed in the cloud, can be protected from manipulation, and much more. However, a byproduct of this is that Ethereum uses a token called Ether, which is like Bitcoin, to transact. Ethereum looks set to break out in 2021. As its technological advantages gain steam, Ethereum investors could see $1,500 in the near term and $2,500 sometime by the end of 2021. Because of its unique abilities, Ethereum has attracted all types of attention, from finance to real estate to investors, software developers, hardware manufacturers, and more. As mentioned, Bitcoin was designed to be a currency. It uses the same underlying technology principles, but uses them to facilitate monetary transactions. Ethereum, on the other hand, was designed to facilitate software processing using a token system called Ether. That Ether has become more valuable as a result of people becoming interested in the technology. That Ether is what people want to invest in. However, there are a lot of apps being developed on Ethereum, and even some major financial companies are getting involved in the space. It could be interesting to see what develops from this over the next few years. Finally, Ethereum is much cheaper than Bitcoin. Bitcoin currently trades for over $31,496 per unit, while Ether trades at just $1,290. The future of Ethereum wasn't always so bright. In June 2016, the infamous DAO hack sent $55 million of Ether into hackers' hands. As a rash of Bitcoin clones like Bitcoin Cash and Dogecoin made Ethereum look like yet another shiny bauble in the massive cryptocurrency soup. But Ethereum quickly recovered. To handle the DAO hack, the Ethereum community decided to effectively roll back its blockchain to undo the damage. It regained its number two position by 2018. Ethereum holds several technological advantages over its older Bitcoin and altcoin siblings. Firstly, the cryptocurrency acts more like a contract than a coin. That makes it more like Alphabet's GOOG, GOOGL, Google Wallet, or Apple's AAPL, Apple Pay, rather than a $100 billion. For instance, an e-commerce buyer might hold ETH in an escrow that automatically releases payment on receipt of goods. Bitcoin, on the other hand, offers no such mechanism. Secondly, Ethereum solves the thorny problem of speed. While Bitcoin takes about 15 minutes to complete a transaction, ETH will do the same in under 15 seconds. Finally, it has a theoretically unlimited supply, unlike Bitcoin's 21 million coin cap. That means ETH won't run into a mining wall and run out of coins to reward miners. That makes Ethereum one of the favorite cryptocurrency plays of 2021. With a $132.5 billion market capitalization, the cryptocurrency is still only one-fifth of the size of Bitcoin. And as an adoption spreads on PayPal and other payment processors, the forgotten middle child could quickly catch up to its older brother. But just like Bitcoin, there is a wrinkle in the Ethereum story. Unlike gold or bonds, Ethereum is not a safe haven asset. Instead, it's a risk-on asset that tends to rise when times are good and fall otherwise. The data backs this up. The correlation between Ethereum and the S&P 500 now sits at 64%, meaning that stocks explain almost two-thirds of Ethereum's monthly returns. Not convinced? Consider 2020, the month the stock market fell out of bed. As the stock market tumbled 30% on coronavirus fears, cryptocurrencies provided no cushion. In a matter of weeks, Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other cryptocurrencies lost over half of their value. The same pattern happened during the December 2018 market wobble. But there is a silver lining. Ethereum also tends to magnify stock market gains. With more fiscal stimulus on the way, that also means higher stock valuations. Cryptocurrencies will naturally follow. Make no mistake, Ethereum is as volatile as a moody teenager. $10,000 invested in January 2018 would have melted to $830 in a year. But that same $10,000 invested in January 2020 would have rocketed to $85,000. Without an underlying hard asset, Ethereum's value has no basis in the real world. That makes the cryptocurrency's valuation more of a popularity contest than a technical exercise, at least in the short term. The cryptocurrency could easily double to $2,500 in 2021 if more users keep jumping on board. But it could also crash to $500 if a major hack shakes investor confidence. More likely, a 25% loss would cause investors to panic sell, sparking a self-fulfilling downward cycle. Ethereum prices also tend to reverse course in the near term. Since 2015, Ethereum returns have doubled back almost 60% of the time, when a winning month gets followed by a losing one and vice versa. Even in its 2018 peak, the coin never notched more than two consecutive months of gains. Ethereum is going to become known as the Internet of Value. Now, at first glance, they may seem like the same thing. Money and value are probably distant synonyms, if not closer, but in this case, they are different representations. While Bitcoin may never become the digital currency it was meant to be, it certainly is turning money on its head. If you're interested in investing in Ethereum, and specifically Ether, you need a digital wallet. Ethereum doesn't trade on any major stock platform. You can't go to your online discount broker and buy Ethereum. You have to convert it into your wallet. It's important to remember that Ether is a currency, and it should be treated as such by investors. You don't buy shares of Ether like you would stocks or ETFs. Instead, you are exchanging your dollars for Ether tokens. There are no dividends, no payouts. Your only hope is that in the future, other people on the internet will pay you more for your tokens than you bought them for. If you're not sure about using a digital wallet and want to invest via an ETF, you can't do it yet. However, there is a Bitcoin ETF, GBTC, and you can invest in it or Ethereum directly on eToro. Investing in Ethereum is risky, but it could potentially be lucrative. Unlike Bitcoin or Litecoin, companies are really using Ethereum as a building block, something more akin to diamonds than gold. As an investor, this is a potential win. Furthermore, there can be splits, example, hard forks, on Ethereum like we recently saw with Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash. This can be a good thing or a bad thing. People who've invested in Bitcoin Cash are happy about the split because they made great money for no effort. However, Ether is still an internet currency, so you should always proceed with caution. Cryptocurrency is but one part of the digitalization and tokenization that is coming. If Ethereum does drive this boom, then it will far exceed even its creators' expectations, or maybe even yours for your portfolio. Let us know down below in the comments if you think Ethereum can take over the digital world and is your best chance to be a millionaire in 2021. And hey, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel so we can continue giving you the best content. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.